Let's discuss electrical conduction in metals. This section we already studied in the section of current electricity. But still, I would like to rediscuss the topic in brief here because it's quite important to understand conduction in semiconductors. As we already know that for a current carrying conductor, current density J is related to drift speed of free electrons as J is equals to NEVD, which we already discussed. And in this situation, this VD is the drift speed of electrons, N is the free electron density, and E is the electronic charge. So in this situation, we also studied that for a conductor, drift speed is directly proportional to the applied electric field in the conductor. This is applied electric field in conductor. And here we can write that drift speed of free electrons can be written as mu e, where mu is a proportionality constant. And this mu is called mobility of charge carriers. In case of metals, charge carriers are only free electrons. So this term does mobility of free electrons. If we substitute it here, then current density can be directly written as J is equals to NE. This drift speed we can write as mu E. So we can write that the current density is directly proportional to the electric field because these three parameters are constant. And this we can write as sigma E. We already studied that here sigma is NE mu is called conductivity of the conductor or of the metal in which we are analyzing the parameters. And here mu is the mobility which is giving us the ease with which charge carriers can flow, which depends mainly on temperature. If temperature of a metal increases, mobility decreases because more number of collisions are there due to thermal agitation, and it decreases the conductivity of metal, which we already studied. Now, in the next article, we are going to study about electrical conduction in semiconductors. So, this analysis, what we have done for metals, is going to help us in analyzing electrical conduction in semiconductors.